Dear students, can you guess what we are going to discuss today? Just look at the pictures and guess. Yes, it's atmospheric pollution. Under this, we are going to discuss number one, acid rain, composition, cause, and its impact. Sulfur in fossil fuels giving oxides of sulfur when burned. High temperatures in furnaces and internal combustion engines produce oxides of nitrogen. Acid rain affects soil chemistry and water bodies. The second topic is global warming. Greenhouse gases, their sources and ways of reducing their presence in the atmosphere. Greenhouse gases like water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, and oxides of nitrogen. Third topic is ozone depletion. Function of ozone in the atmosphere, formation of ozone along with relevant equations, destruction of ozone layer. Now let us see what we mean by environment. The biological and physical world around us is known as our environment. By biological world we mean the trees, the plants, the animals, the birds around us. And by physical world, we mean the land, the water, the sun, the clouds, etc. Now, what is atmospheric pollution? Atmospheric pollution means the degradation of the quality of air caused by natural processes as well as human activities. Now, what are the natural causes of pollution? Volcanic eruptions, forest fires, dust storms, and decaying vegetation. Volcanic eruptions. These eruptions pollute vast areas of atmosphere with sulfur dioxide gas and volcanic ash. Forest fire. Forest fires release carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and many other harmful gases. Dust storms. Stormy winds cause soil erosion, and this results in addition of large quantities of dust particles to the atmosphere. Decaying vegetation. Plants produce volatile organic compounds, VOCs, when they decay. These VOCs increase Earth's temperature, thereby causing global warming. Pollution due to human activities. Vehicular pollution, deforestation, pollution due to industries all add up to polluting the atmosphere. Now let us see what acid rain is. Normal rainwater is slightly acidic due to dissolved carbon dioxide. But if pH of rainwater lies between 5.6 and 2.0, then it is acid rain. How is acid rain caused? Acid rain is caused by the dissolution of oxides of sulfur and nitrogen in rainwater. Acid rain consists of mineral acids like sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, etc. How is sulfur dioxide added in the atmosphere? There are many ways by which sulfur dioxide reaches the atmosphere. Let us discuss a few of them. By burning fossil fuel. Fossil fuels are the long dead remains of plants and animals. The small amount of sulfur present in them burn to form sulfur dioxide gas in addition to carbon dioxide formed by burning of carbon. Sulfur plus oxygen gives sulfur dioxide. S plus O2 gives SO2. Carbon plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide. sulfur dioxide also reaches the atmosphere through thermoelectric plants used for generating electricity from coal. Even petroleum refineries add sulfur dioxide to our atmosphere. Industries where ores are refined and where fertilizers are manufactured, the concentration of sulfur dioxide gas is very high. How this sulfur dioxide gets converted to sulfurous and sulfuric acid? Let us see some equations. Now, already we have discussed about sulfur combining with oxygen to give sulfur dioxide. Sometimes excess of sulfur combines with excess of oxygen to produce sulfur dioxide. That is the second equation you can see. This sulfur dioxide burns in oxygen to give sulfur trioxide. Sulfur dioxide is SO2 and sulfur trioxide is SO3. The sulfur dioxide gas thus formed dissolves in water to form sulfurous acid. SO2 plus H2O gives sulfurous acid. Sulfurous acid is H2SO3, and the sulfur trioxide gas dissolves in water to form sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Sulfur trioxide, that is SO3, dissolves in water, that is H2O, to give H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Now, how nitrogen dioxide is added in the atmosphere? When fuels burn in furnaces, automobiles, combustible engines, etc., due to high temperature, the nitrogen and oxygen present in the air combine to form nitric oxide gas. Nitrogen plus oxygen forms nitric oxide. N2 plus O2 gives 2NO. This nitric oxide, that is NO gas, is released through chimneys, and when it comes in contact with atmospheric oxygen, it forms nitrogen dioxide gas. NO, that is nitric oxide, combines with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. NO is nitric oxide. NO2 is nitrogen dioxide. Another natural way of forming nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide is during lightning, due to electric discharge. Conversion of nitrogen dioxide into acid. The following equation will help you to understand how nitrogen dioxide gas changes to nitric acid. 4NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide, plus 2H2O, that is water, combines with oxygen to form nitric acid, that is 4HNO3. So 4NO2 plus 2H2O plus O2 gives us 4HNO3, nitric acid. When these acids present in the water vapor condense and precipitate to form rain, the rain water is acidic in nature, which we usually call as acid rain. Impacts of acid rain. Acid rain has the following harmful effects. Plants grow well in slightly alkaline or neutral soil, but due to acid rain, the acidity of the soil increases, thereby turning fields infertile. Acid rain harm aquatic life. It kills large number of water plants as well as animals. Marble and cement structures also get damaged due to acid rain. A very good example is of our Taj Mahal. Since acid corrodes metals, buildings and bridges made with metals get damaged.